نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونستهديه، ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا وسيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له، ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله وصفيه وخليله، بلغ الرسالة وأدى الأمانة ونصح للأمة، وتركنا على المحجة البيضاء ليلها كنهارها لا يزيغ عنها إلا هالك. فصلوات ربي وسلامه عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه ومن اهتدى بهديه وسار على سنته إلى يوم الدين. عباد الله، أوصيكم ونفسي أولاً بتقوى الله تعالى وطاعته ولزوم أوامره وكثرة مخافته، فإنها شعار المؤمنين ودثار المتقين ووصية الله في وفيكم أجمعين. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم، إن زلزلة الساعة شيء عظيم، يوم ترونها تذهل كل مرضعة عما أرضعت، وتضع كل ذات حمل حملها، وترى الناس سكارى وما هم بسكارى ولكن عذاب الله شديد. إخوتي في الله، ما زلنا في تأملاتنا مع هجرة رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم، وهذا العام الهجري الجديد الذي استفتحناه بفضل الله عز وجل بموسم من مواسم الخير، وهو بالأمس ليلة عاشوراء وصيام ليلة عاشوراء، تلك الليلة التي ذلك اليوم الذي وصفه رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم بأن صوم يوم عاشوراء يكفر السنة الماضية. وعن ابن عباس رضي الله عنه أنه قال، وهي كلها هذه الأحاديث في الصحاح، أن رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم ما كان يتحرى صيام يوم كتحريه يوم عاشوراء وصيام يوم عاشوراء. وقبل وفاته صلى الله عليه وسلم قال: لئن عشت إلى قابل لأصومن التاسع والعاشر، وفي رواية لأصومن يوما قبله أو يوما بعده. فنسأل الله عز وجل أن يتقبل ممن صام، وأن يعيد هذه الأيام والمواسم على الأمة بخير وفضل وكرم. إخواني الأحبة، تأملاتنا في هذه الهجرة وربطها بهذا العام الجديد الذي نستفتحه، عام 1440 من الهجرة، يجب أن يكون في ذهن كل واحد منا، لمن قرأ السنن والسير، بأن الهجرة هي ليست انتقال من أرض إلى أرض، وإنما روح الهجرة ومفهوم الهجرة في الإسلام هو هجرة إلى الله عز وجل. حينما قال عليه الصلاة والسلام في الحديث الصحيح: إنما الأعمال بالنيات، وإنما لكل امرئ ما نوى. كيف دلل على هذا المعنى؟ قال: فمن كانت هجرته إلى الله ورسوله فهجرته إلى الله ورسوله، ومن كانت هجرته لدنيا يصيبها أو امرأة ينكحها فهجرته إلى ما هاجر إليه. وفي الحديث الصحيح كذلك قال عليه الصلاة والسلام: ألا أخبركم بالمؤمن؟ تحبوا تعرفوا تعريف المؤمن؟ ثم أخبر الصحابة رضوان الله عليهم من هو المؤمن. قال: من أمن الناس على أموالهم وأنفسهم والمسلم من سلم الناس من لسانه ويده، والمجاهد من جاهد نفسه على طاعة الله. ثم قال عليه الصلاة والسلام: والمهاجر من هجر الخطايا والذنوب. الهجرة هي أن تبعد بنفسك وبقلبك وبنيتك وبواقعك عن ما يغضب الله عز وجل، سواء كان ذلك أرض تفتن فيها ويفتن فيها دينك وليس لها فيها مكان لممارسة هذا الدين وشعائر حياتك، أو كانت معصية يجب أن تهاجر عنها أو تبتعد عنها. كلما تأملت إخواني الأحبة في الهجرة ودروس المستقى من هذه الهجرة العظيمة، كلما رأيت عظمة الصحابة رضوان الله عليهم، كيف أن الله عز وجل وفقهم في أن تكون الهجرة هي مصدر التاريخ ومركز التاريخ بالنسبة لأحداث الأمة. كنا قبل إخواني الأحبة أن البعض يظن أن الهجرة هي فرار وهروب، ولكن هذا ليس بصحيح. فرسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم الذي كان يقول أمام الرغائب وأمام الترهيب، الترغيب والترهيب من مشركي مكة، يقول لهم: والله لو وضعوا الشمس في يميني، لما قال لعمه: يا عماه لو وضعوا الشمس في يميني والقمر في شمالي على أن أترك هذا الدين أو يظهره الله أو أموت دونه، أو كما قال عليه الصلاة والسلام. هذا النبي اللي يقول لك لو وضعوا الشمس في يميني والقمر في يساري على أن أترك هذا الدين ما تركته إلا أن يظهره الله عز وجل أو أهلك دونه، ما يغادر مكة إلا لحكمة عظيمة. وما تؤرخ التاريخ بالهجرة إلا لأنها حدث عظيم في تاريخ الأمة إخواني الأحبة وفي ذاكرتها. ولذلك يجب أن نستلهم هذه الدروس. هذا النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم بذل أقصى جهده، وكما وصفه الصحابة رضوان الله عليهم أنه من جاء أمر الله عز وجل: يا أيها المدثر قم فأنذر، قالوا: فقام رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم فلم ينم أو فلم يجلس حتى لقي ربه، وهو يجاهد وينافح ويكافح ويدعو إلى الله عز وجل داعيا ومبشرا ونذيرا. لكن حينما أسنت مكة وأرض مكة والدعوة في مكة، ولم يعد هناك مجال أو تربة صالحة للدعوة، كان لابد من التغيير. حينما يأتي رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم يتحرك، يأتي إلى فلان وإلى فلان، وعمه أقرب الناس إليه وأكثر الناس علاقة قوية بينهم قبل أن يؤتى بالرسالة عليه الصلاة والسلام، يسير خلفه، وكلما تكلم مع وفد أو مع ناس قادمين إلى مكة بعد ما يروح الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم يذهب إليهم ويقول: ماذا قال لكم؟ لا تصدقوه، هذا أفاك، هذا ساحر، هذا كذا، هذا كذا، أنا أدرى الناس به، أنا عمه. يقول الرواة أنه يعني حينما يكون قد قاربوا أن يتأثروا وأن يدخل الإيمان في قلوبهم والإسلام ويحبوا، يأتي هذا العم فيقول: وما لنا ولهذا الدين، هذا أعلم بابن أخيه وأهل مكة أدرى بشعابها كما يقولون. فوصلت مرحلة كان لابد من الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم أن يبحث في التغيير، فيذهب إلى الطائف ويرد، ويبدأ يقابل الوفود ويقابل وفد من يثرب، وإذا بها تصبح المدينة التي استنارت برسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم ثم أنارت البشرية كلها. هذه أكبر دروس الهجرة إخواني الأحبة، عملية التغيير، عملية بذل الجهد من أجل أن تغير الواقع
المرير الذي أنت تعيشه. ومع ذلك إخواني الأحبة، هذا العام الجديد يتطلب من كل واحد منا أن ينظر ماذا يحتاج من أن يغير، فيبدأ بعملية التغيير ويستلهم من الهجرة الجهد العظيم الذي بذله رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم، والأسباب التي أخذها رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم في الهجرة، وكلها من أجل أن يكون التغيير تغيير صالح وناجح من واقع مرير تعيشه، سواء كان ذلك في علاقاتك الزوجية أو في تعاملاتك أو في تجارتك أو في غيرها من الأمور التي فيها فشل متواصل، تحتاج إلى التغيير وتحتاج إلى بذل الجهد، ونستلهم ذلك من الهجرة في هذا العام الجديد. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر لكم فاستغفروه. الحمد لله كما أمر، والصلاة والسلام على خير البشر محمد بن عبد الله وعلى آله وأصحابه الميمين الغرى المتصلة عين بنظر وأذن بخبر وسلم تسليما كثيرا. Dear brothers and sisters, I bear witness that there is no God but Allah, and I bear witness that Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم is his servant and his messenger, peace be upon him and upon all the messengers of Allah from the time of Adam through Ibrahim, Musa, Isa and the seal of the prophets, Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon all of them. Dear brothers and sisters, we continue what we started in the previous khutbah by reflecting and having reflections on the great lessons of the immigration and the migration of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, al-hijrah, and the new Hijri year 1440 that started 10 days ago. And we praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that we are starting this new year with the first season of great reward from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and opportunity, and that is by the fasting of yesterday, which is the 10th of Muharram, which is Ashura. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam encouraged the Sahaba to fast a day of Ashura and one day before or one day after, as it is mentioned in the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. When the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam arrived and came to Medina, and he observed that the Jews are fasting this day, and he asked them, why you are fasting it? They said, we are fasting it because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in such a day, in this day, saved Moses and his companions from Fir'aun. And Musa alayhi salam, peace be upon him, he fasted that day thanking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, نَحْنُ أَوْلَى بِمُوسَى مِنْكُمْ. He said, Musa is my brother. Musa is the messenger of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We are more entitled of thanking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and fasting this day than you. So he fasted the day of Ashura and he ordered the companions to fast that day. And later on, it became an optional. It is not something that is they have to do it. But he said that fasting the day of Ashura, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will wipe the sins of the previous year. And before his death, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, if I will live for next year, I will fast the 9th and the 10th to differ and to have their own identity different than what the Jews are doing. And in another hadith, I will fast a day before or a day after. And this is why, alhamdulillah, the Muslim community here are, Islamic society is planning today, which is the 11th, fasting at the Maghrib time. So may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reward them for having this kind of beautiful sunnah and encouragement for the community. Dear brothers and sisters, as I said before, that migration is not running from one place to another place. It's not traveling from one place and abandoning one place and running to another location. It's not physical in the sense of changing locations. But hijrah is migration to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. All of you migrating to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. With your feelings, with your intentions, with your emotions, with your dreams, with your goals. And if that is required to be physical, then physical becomes part of it. And this is not something that we are making up or trying to add to this definition, dear brothers and sisters. This is clearly stated in the ahadith, authentic ahadith by the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said in the most authentic and famous hadith about the intention, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "Innamal a'malu bin niyat." Deeds are by intentions. وَلِكُلِّ امْرِئٍ مَّا نَوَى. And everyone is entitled and rewarded according to their intentions. فَمَنْ كَانَتْ هِجْرَتُهُ لِلَّهِ وَرَسُولِهِ فَهِجْرَتُهُ لِلَّهِ وَرَسُولِهِ. Whoever migrate for the sake of Allah and following the sunnah and the commands of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, then his migration for this noble cause. وَمَنْ كَانَتْ هِجْرَتُهُ لِدُنْيَا يُصِيبُهَا أَوْ امْرَأَةٍ يَنْكِحُهَا فَهِجْرَتُهُ إِلَى مَا هَاجَرَ إِلَيْهِ. But if your migration is for worldly benefit and or to seek to get married from this woman or that woman, then your migration is for whatever you are migrating for. Clearly here is the Prophet is telling us, it's not the issue is about, it's not the purpose of it, is just migration. The goal is not to just move from one place to another, but the migration has to be for Allah and His Messenger, for things that will please Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and His Messenger. So, in another hadith, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, and this was during Hajjatul Wada', the farewell pilgrimage, he asked the companions, do you want me to tell you who is considered a mu'min, a believer? And then the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam answered that question. He said, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, المؤمن من أمن الناس على أموالهم وأنفسهم. That the true believer is the one that the people feel safe from him or her when it comes to their wealth or to their self, their beings. And the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, والمسلم, and the Muslim is the one من سلم الناس من لسانه ويده. A true Muslim is the one who the people are safe from his tongue and his hand, from the consequences of hurting them physically or verbally. And then the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, and this is where it is related to this khutbah, وَالْمُجَاهِدُ مَنْ جَاهَدَ نَفْسَهُ فِي طَاعَةِ اللَّهِ. The true mujahid is the one who make jihad in following the commands of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and being obedient to Allah. وَالْمُهَاجِرُ مَنْ هَجَرَ الْخَطَايَا وَالذُّنُوبِ. And the true immigrant, the true muhajir, the true immigrant is the one who migrate away from the sins and committing evil acts. So that has becomes so clear related to the concept of immigration or migration, and that is exactly what's the whole purpose of migration when it comes to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. It's not running away. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, who was calling for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he was, his answer towards all these forms of negotiations with the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and trying him to compromise his deen, what was? One time they will give him a lot of good offers, and another time they will threaten him. What was the response when they put that deal and both of those issues in front of him through his uncle Abu Talib? His response was, Ya Ammah, O my uncle, Wallahi la wada'u shamsa fi yamini. Wallah, even if they will put the whole sun and bring it and put it in my right hand. والقمر في شمالي, and the moon in my left hand. I will not give up on my deen, on this message, either unless Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give it victory, or I will perish for the sake of this message. That was the message of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. That was the stand of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam in front of any forms of negotiations or compromise with him. Then why then the Prophet ﷺ, who have that clear steadfast on the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, why then he will migrate and leave Mecca? When the Prophet ﷺ left Mecca, he looked around back to the Mecca and he said, Wallahi, إِنَّكِ لَأَحَبُّ الْبِلَادِ إِلَىٰ قَلْبِي. You are the most beloved land to me. This is his homeland. All the memories that he lived with in Mecca, all the traces and the heritage of his great father Ibrahim is all in Mecca. And yet he is now leaving it and he is saying, if it was not that your people made it impossible that the da'wah will be established in Mecca, otherwise I will stay. So what do we learn from the hijrah, dear brothers and sisters? Because this is what we are doing. In the previous khutbah, we took one lesson from the hijrah and we related it to the new hijri year that we are celebrating and the ummah is celebrating. New year in our life, in the life of each one of us. And today, inshallah, we will take another lesson. And then we will relate it again to this new year. And hopefully, inshallah, next Friday, we will have one more. But there is something that is so clear. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, from the day Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed to him, يا أيها المدثر قم فأنذر. Oh, the one who is wrapped with the garment, stand up and deliver the message. And as I mentioned before, the Sahaba radwanullah alayhim said that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, from that moment of this verse, revelation of this verse, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam never rested, never had any time to rest until he met Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. 23 years of da'wah and jihad and strive in the cause of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But there was a point where Mecca become something that is dry. There is no more hope for the da'wah in the environment of Mecca. It becomes not positive and productive to stay in Mecca for the sake of the da'wah, not for the sake of him. This is when the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, by the command of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, started the process of migration. When he is going around approaching the people and visitors are coming to Hajj for Mecca, and he will go to them and show them and talk to them and make da'wah to them and tell them about the new message and that he is the messenger of Allah. And his own uncle, Abu Lahab, his own uncle, he will go after him, walk behind him, describing him as a liar. And he will wait, Abu Lahab will wait for the Prophet ﷺ when he is done talking to the people. And he is there, as the narrators of that seerah is telling, that they are so close now, they are start to love the message. And the minute the Prophet ﷺ leave, his own uncle will come to those people and he will ask them, what did he talk to you about? Don't believe in him. He is a magician. He is a liar. He is this. He is that. I am his own uncle, Abdul Uzza, Abu Lahab. I am his own uncle. I know him. And this is when those start turning those people away. They will say, oh, he knows his nephew better than us. We are just visitors over here. So then the Prophet ﷺ did not give up. At most effort, will go all the way to At-Ta'if to deliver the message. And he is being kicked out of and humiliated from At-Ta'if. Never gave up until Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala prepared that opportunity where the people of Medina was the lucky one, the blessed one. And the Medina was enlightened with the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and later on the Medina enlightened the whole world with that great message of Al-Islam. But it is that effort, dear brothers and sisters, and not just only the utmost effort, but the utmost preparation and taking the means, al-akhd bil-asbab. A prophet of Allah, who the sky and the heaven will be waiting for him in al-Isra and al-Mi'raj as a visitor. The whole laws of universe has been interrupted for his sake. Yet, he will make hidden the day of the Hijrah. He will hire and have his cousin Ali, may Allah be pleased with him, sleep in his bed in order to deceive those who are trying to stop him and assassinate him. He will go and turn and start his journey in the opposite direction of Mecca, of Medina, in order to mislead the army of the pagans. He will hire an expert to in roads in order to show him the way. He will have a shepherd to come and with his sheep wipe and erase all the marks that may lead to them. He will go and hide and stay in a small cave for days. So all of this, the change that he is striving for, will be a successful change. What a powerful lesson, dear brothers and sisters. Doing your utmost and making sure that you do all the efforts and all the means and all what is needed in order to make sure that that change is successful. How do we learn from this when we are starting a new year in our life? Do we start our new year, dear brothers and sisters, by recycling the same mistakes again and again? People come to me and they have problems with their wives or with their husbands. What did you do to change? It's the same thing. They go back and they try the things that they already tried and it didn't work. Why? We did not learn from the Hijrah. We did not learn of taking and finding all the means to make sure that that change is successful. The same thing with relationships, the same thing with even your commerce or trade or merchants. Same failures, and we do the same thing and we don't learn that you need to take new measures. You need to learn from your deen how to reapproach things in a different way. That you have to sacrifice and you have to give up on some certain bad habits here or there that is ruining your marriage or ruining your trade or ruining your business or your job or your relationship with friends or with the community. We cannot keep recycling the same mistakes when we see the Prophet ﷺ did his utmost and took all the measures needed to make sure that a new start will be in Medina by making this change succeed. We have the same responsibility, even as a community. Even as a community, dear brothers and sisters, who are living over here, it's very important that we always revisit the issues. All issues, everything on the table should be. And we have to always ask ourselves, what are things that are we are doing it again and again, and they are failures again and again, or the results are very limited. And we have to have the courage. We have to have the courage to learn from the hijrah of the Prophet ﷺ by doing the effort and trying something new. So hopefully, the da'wah to continue in Mecca, there is another heaven waiting in Medina that can make a difference. This is, can be applied, dear brothers and sisters, in every aspect of our life as individuals, as families, as communities. Especially when we are starting the new year of the hijrah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. اللهم اجعلنا من الذين يستمعون القول فيتبعون احسنه هذا واعلموا ان الله قد امركم بامر بدا بنفسه وثنى بالملائكه القدسي فقال جل من قال ان الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا ايها الذين امنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما اللهم صل على محمد وعلى ال محمد كما صليت على ابراهيم وعلى ابراهيم انك حميد مجيد اللهم بارك على محمد وعلى ال محمد كما باركت على ابراهيم وعلى ابراهيم انك حميد مجيد اللهم اهدنا فيمن هديت وعافنا فيمن عافيت وتولنا فيمن توليت وبارك لنا فيما اعطيت وقنا واصرف عنا برحمتك شر ما قضيت وقنا واصرف عنا برحمتك شر ما قضيت وقنا واصرف عنا برحمتك شر ما قضيت فانك تقضي بالحق ولا يقضى عليك انه لا يذل من وليت ولا يعز من عاديت تباركت ربنا وتعاليت اللهم اجعل جمعنا هذا جمعا مرحوما وتفرقنا من بعده تفرقا معصوما ولا تجعل فينا ولا منا ولا بيننا شقيا ولا محروما اللهم لا تدع لنا في مقامنا ذنبا إلا غفرته ولا هما إلا فرجته ولا كربا إلا نفسته ولا عسيرا إلا يسرته ولا محتاجا إلا كفيته ولا مريضا إلا شفيته ولا مريضا إلا شفيته ولا مريضا إلا شفيته ولا ميتا إلا رحمته ولا مظلوما إلا أيدته ولا ظالما جبارا إلا قصمته، ولا مجاهدا في سبيلك إلا نصرته، ولا ولدا إلا أصلحته، ولا زوجا إلا حفظته، ولا غائبا إلا بالسلامة إلى أهله رددته، برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. سبحان ربك رب العزة عما يصفون، وسلام على المرسلين، والحمد لله رب العالمين، وصلى الله وسلم على حبيبنا وقرة عيوننا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين، وأقم الصلاة.